see you. The way I breathe you in is the texture of your skin. I wanna wrap my arms around you, baby, never let you go.
Good morning, Colonel Bai. It's Monday, April 19th.
I'm Anna.
And I'm Sasha.
And here are your morning announcements.
Did you enroll in summer school? If yes, you will be receiving an email from PRISM in the next couple of weeks to confirm your registration.
Please note all summer school programs have gone virtual. Some programs are being offered both synchronously and asynchronously learning throughout the school day.
Other programs will be running asynchronously. To check how your program will be running, please check the OCDSB Summer School website.
Remember, it's your responsibility to double-check your registration. If you've changed your mind about summer school, have an error in your registration, or have any questions at all, please contact your guidance counselor ASAP.
If you have not already registered or you would like to, the Reach Ahead Summer School registration form and information can be found on the guidance website.
Remember, all summer school programs have gone virtual, and if you have any questions at all, please contact your guidance counselor.
This week, Monday showed Interview a Club. Let's go check it out.
Hey Cougars, today I'm here with Miriam, and she's one of the executives of Feminism Club here at Colonel Bai. So Miriam, can you tell me a little bit more about what Feminism Club entails?
We hold meetings every other Saturday. Our next meeting is actually Saturday the 24th of April. And what we do at those meetings is they're very discussion-based. We send out the discussion topic ahead of time, and we research some materials and a queer presentation so that as a club we can just sort of discuss a lot of these topics that bring up. Some previous topics that we've spoken of was ableism and the context of that within the pandemic. We've spoken of representation in media of marginalized groups and how that will affect one's perception. And we try to make it a very inclusive and very open and safe place to discuss these things as much as possible, and to bring in lots of different perspectives.
Wow, your meetings sound like they would be very interesting. Now, we know that COVID has really changed almost everything around Colonel Bai, including clubs. So how has your club adapted, and how have you had to change what you used to do?
The main adaptation is that a lot of the projects we do, like normally our projects that we do, like International Women's Week or even for Violence Against Women, normally those campaigns would involve a lot of in-person interaction with the student body. So, and lots of decoration of the atrium too, for example. So we've had to switch a lot of that online. Our main method being like through Instagram campaigns and through lots of infographics.
Well, it's great to hear that even under these weird circumstances, your club is running smoothly. Now, Miriam, why should somebody join Feminism Club if they were thinking about it?
We do a lot of cool stuff with Feminism Club that I think a lot of people would be really interested in to take part in. And overall, I think what's great about Feminism Club is it's a safe space to talk about these issues, to bring it up and to talk about your own experiences or your own perspectives. And those are all important things that need to be brought to the conversation. And I think Fem Club is a great place to have that.
That all sounds so great, Miriam, and thank you so much for speaking with me today. If you guys are interested in checking out Feminism Club, you can send them a DM at their Instagram, @cb.feminism, or you can go to the club directory and email one of their executives. Back to you guys.
Seems interesting to me. Make sure to check them out, Cougars.
Are you concerned of the explicit rise of anti-Asian racism and want to participate in discussions?
If you are, please fill out the Google form on the Colonel Bai website under School News.
If you have any questions at all, please contact Mr. Pai or Ms. Na.
With the recent lockdown, we're all wondering how the vaccine rollout is happening. Let's go check out what's new.
Hello, Cougars. As we all know, we've been in phase one of the vaccine rollout. This, of course, includes high-risk populations, such as healthcare workers and seniors, etc. But recently we've moved into phase two, classified as the mass delivery of vaccines. A big part of this is the vaccination of 18 plus individuals who live in high-risk areas. Unfortunately, or fortunately, depending on how you choose to look at it, most of us live in the K1J postcode, which is unfortunately not a hotspot. This means the people in our area, newly eligible for the vaccine, are the special education workers, the education workers for elementary and secondary schools, and individuals 55 and up. If you live in the postal codes K1T, K1V, or K2V, you live in a hotspot, so you should check out this website to double check your eligibility. If you can get it, you definitely should. Back to you, Sasha and Anna.
Looks like we'll be vaccinated this time next year.
Are you a creative writer looking to be published? Do you want to win cool prizes like Colonel By merch?
Well, you should enter Right Away's creative writing contest open to all Colonel By students grade 9 to 12.
Submissions are due by today. For more information, go to colonelbynews.com or contact the email down below.
We got the chance to ask students at CB how they're feeling about going back online. Let's go check it out.
I got the chance to ask some Colonel By students how they feel about this new online learning system. Let's go see what they have to say.
So, at the beginning, I actually really enjoyed it because I could just roll out of bed and I'd be ready for school in the mornings. But now, as I'm getting closer and closer to the end of the school year and like the end of high school, I feel like it's really starting to hit me how much I've missed out on, both academically and socially. Because personally, I find it so much harder to retain information when you're doing the classes online. And also, like, you miss out on those fun school memories, like with your peers, with your friends, and with your teachers. So, like, overall, I'm not a huge fan of online learning just because it's taking all those good memories, the good parts of school away. But I mean, it's understandable in circumstances like these.
Hi, my name's Anna, and I personally think that online school is okay. It's pretty well organized. I think the model for this octomester is a lot better than the one that we had after Christmas break. I think it honestly depends on what classes you have. I mean, I have math for this octomester at home, so I'm not looking forward to that because I find it easier to learn math in person, but I think for other classes it might be a bit easier. I guess we'll just have to see.
I think it's a good thing that we all stay indoors, at least at home, in our own little bubbles for now to reduce the spread of COVID. But I will miss seeing my teachers and my friends at school.
My name is Anne and I'm a grade 12 student at Colonel By. And personally, I don't like the new online program of two classes a day because first of all, I don't get to have my spare of 1 week. And I find that it's a little harder on us mentally than it would be than one class.
So online learning's back. Personally, I've always liked it a lot because I got to work in my own environment. And it made testing really easy for me because there wasn't the stress of being in a classroom. So I just felt like better being able to do this stuff at home. But I'm really gonna miss the effect of like socialization with people in school. It was always really fun for me personally. I liked talking to people a lot at school and just generally seeing people. But it is what it is to stop COVID, so I understand. Stay safe, stay home. I'm just gonna try to stay on top of my work, and you all should too.
The YMCA Summer Work Student Exchange is a national program offering opportunities to youth to improve their second language skills, explore Canada, and gain valuable work experience.
Their program is federally funded by the Department of Canadian Heritage, so it is offered at a minimum price of $125.
For more information, go to the Cool Opportunities link in the guidance website.
Now let's go check out our Cougar of the Week.
This week's Cougar of the Week is Cameron McNaught. He's a grade 9 student who enjoys fooling around with his friends, likes to skateboard, and likes to play the guitar and sing. If you have him on social media, be sure to say hi.
Thank you to all the Colonel By students who made 608 Easter cards for seniors and frontline workers at 6 local retirement homes. Your efforts were greatly appreciated.
That's all from us today, CB. Have a Macklemore Monday.